السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. نأسف we apologize for the delay because we have technical problems again for the showing the slideshow for the second day. Seems that we have some problem with the technical problem with the computer. Anyway, today we'll talk about the herd immunity, which we spoke about it yesterday in Arabic. And why we talk about herd immunity as a new strategy, because this has been mentioned by many politicians over the last few months, from America, from UK, from Sudan, and from others. And most of the politicians are so scared to leave this problem of COVID actually without actually having a final solution for it. It's very badly affecting the economy of all the countries globally. That's why today we'll be talking about a herd community. Why we talk about herd community today, 4 months after the, or 5 months after we started to make the lockdown of COVID-19? Because many people talked about the another attack of COVID-19 in the autumn, and the strategy, and using the strategy of herd immunity, which they were not going to make the lockdown and leave every one of us be responsible for his safety or her safety, unfortunately. So while we are talking about it, let me remind you of the update of the number of infected people on the globe. Is 14,935,635. This is up to today, and the number of dead, 616,338 cases. That means over 4% died, unfortunately. When I was reading one of the article about from Mayo Clinic in America, it's mayoclinic.org, June 6, 2020, about herd immunity and COVID-19, what you need to know about herd immunity. It occurs when a large portion of the community, the herd, becomes immune to the disease, making the spread of disease from person to person unlikely. As a result, the whole community becomes protected, not just those who are immune. Often a percentage of population must be capable of getting a disease in order for it to spread. Yeah, that's what they are saying in the report in Mayo Clinic. This is called threshold proportion. But the threshold proportion is a percentage of a population must be capable of getting a disease in order for it to spread if the proportion of the population that's immune to the disease is greater than the threshold, the spread of the disease will decline. This is known as herd immunity threshold. Another question we need to ask all of us: what percentage of a community needs to be immune in order to achieve herd immunity? What percentage of community needs to be immune in order to achieve herd immunity? It varies from disease to disease. The more contagious disease, which is a more infectious disease, is, the greater the proportion of the population that needs to be immune to the disease to stop the spread. For example, in the case of measles is highly contagious illness. It's estimated that 94% of the population must be immune to interrupt the change of transmission. So in measles, we need about 90% of the people to be immune against the disease before stopping the spread of the disease. Another question, how is herd immunity achieved? How can we achieve the herd immunity? There are two ways, or two paths of COVID-19. Either one through vaccines, which is not available at the moment. You will achieve this kind of herd immunity during with the vaccine, which is not available at the moment. The second one, natural infection. When such a number of people in the population have recovered from a disease and have developed antibodies against the future infection. Either we have this big number of people who have been infected, then they recover from the disease and they have the antibodies in their bodies, or you have the vaccine and you have the vaccination from it. Another question, how can we slow the transmission of COVID-19? All this from the report of Mayo Clinic in June 4th. Until a COVID-19 vaccine is developed, we cannot slow it down. It's crucial to slow the spread of COVID-19 virus and to protect the individuals at increased risk of severe illnesses, including older adults and people of any age with underlying health condition. So the only way to slow down the transmission is through developing COVID-19 vaccine. Let us go and talk about the politicians now. This is actually what Mayo Clinic mentions, as I mentioned to you earlier at the beginning. Please, there is, Ali put the presentation on the link, the link of the presentation in the comments. What politicians and scientists talk about herd immunity? All of us, we know what Boris Johnson mentioned in March about herd community, and are going to be expected the loved ones, especially the elderly one, will unfortunately die from that. Herd immunity mentioned by him in March 2020 this year. But scientists are warning us against the strategic policy which will lead to be inundated with number of patients that they cannot deal with. And if we do it, the scientists say that we might not be able to deal with the increased number of the people infected by the disease. One of those scientists is Jeremy Rossman from Kent University, who said herd immunity might not be effective in COVID-19. Why? Because the virus keeps developing itself genetically and in behavior. And the virus, according to Jeremy Rossman, keeps developing itself genetically and in behavior. That's why herd immunity might not be the successful way for us. Mark Woolhouse of Edinburgh University also said herd immunity will never stop the spread of a disease completely in population that have not developed immunity against it. That if we have not developed immunity against the disease, herd immunity will never stop the spread of the disease. Zhang Shan, Nanshan, Chinese pulmonologist, said also there is no scientific evidence to support the opinion of if a person or persons are infected, they cannot be infected again. Not once you are infected, you cannot be infected. That is actually, there is no proof for that. This is the argument between the politician and the scientists. In my view, there's another drawing which unfortunately I cannot show it because there's some technical problem here. I draw four outer circles to show the philosophy of my thinking. It's based on belief, based on civil liberty, space and freedom, based on no fear or horror policy, and based on optimism. So if we look at those four points of philosophical thinking in my presentation, we should not, you know, we should look at them, because we are going to be left alone if herd immunity policy and strategy will be left to us. That means that each one of us will be responsible for his or her safety, and for his or her safety and his families and or her family. So these four philosophical principles believe. So I'm talking to anyone who believes in God, generally speaking. No matter who God is, we have to believe that God has decided already that we will die on a certain date. So we should not be afraid of death. This number one. We should demand for a civil liberty, space, and freedom. This will enable us what? To be innovative in finding solution through the initiative that we can take to find such solution with our colleagues. Number four principle in my philosophy is no fear, no horror. Because fear and horror, which has been made and created by politicians or by media or by wrong information on Facebook and others, social media platforms, will lead us to be in a state of depression and withdrawal, and this will affect our immune system. On the contrary, that we have to be in a very optimistic way of trying to fight back this kind of climate which is surrounding us of fear and horror and death and infection. This is the philosophy of my discussion with you today. Since the responsibility will be based on our response to deal with the herd community or the herd immunity philosophy or strategy, each one of us has to strengthen his defense mechanism against the infection itself. On three parts. Number one, we have to strengthen our immune system through, this will constitute about 25% of our struggle or our policy. Strengthening our immune system through taking good food, such as enough water, garlic, spinach, fish, cod liver oil, cod liver, citrus fruits, apricot, almonds, walnuts, ginger, redl, carob, turmeric, vitamins A, B6, B12, C, D, E, red pepper, chicken, broccoli, iron, copper, zinc, vegetable with high level fibers, green tea, sweet potato, berries, yogurt, sour milk, sunflower seeds, black seed oil, rapeseed water, turnip, kale, cheese, homemade pickle, as well as others. So in our 25% of our presentation is how to strengthen our immune system through taking good food. Second point here in this how to strengthen our immune system is body care. Body care through good rest, enough sleep, good exposure to sunshine, psychological comfort and well-being, fasting, prayers, supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or to your Lord. I'm not trying actually to tell you what to do. Yani sports activities, charitable activities. People might say, we understand body care, body rest, enough sleep, good exposure to sunshine. What is fasting to do with the immune system? Fasting cleanses the body of the individual and morally, spiritually strengthen the body itself. charitable activities putting you in a status which will let you to be feeling that you are doing a worthwhile thing to help and save other people. And this will put you in a very motivating status which help your immune system to be stronger. Charitable activity, sports activity, fasting, prayer, supplication, good rest, enough sleep, good exposure to sunshine, psychological comfort, and well-being. This is when we talk about how to increase the immune system for us to face alone the herd immunity philosophy of thinking or a strategy which might actually affect us in winter this year. So 25% of our efforts should be spent on how to strengthen our herd immunity. The second 25%, which you call it too much of a good thing is a bad thing. Too much of good thing is a bad thing. Bad thing never becomes good for you forever. Too much of a good thing is a bad thing, and bad thing never becomes good for you. How to explain this? Too much of good thing is bad thing. This is another 25%. 25% for the how to protect the immune system, 25% is too much of good thing is a bad thing. First of it is too much of taking food and drink. It affects the heart, it affects the liver, it affects the lung, it affects the spleen, it affects the digestive system as a whole, it affects the well-being of the body, of the individual itself. And it makes a burden on all these organs to deal with the excessive amount of food and drink that we are taking. Excessive and harsh sports activities such as boxing, such as wrestling, even rugby, which is very physically contacting one another with it, if excessive of these things will actually lead to injury, lead to exhaustion, and. Putting yourself and myself in the state of despair, anxiety, and stress, because this definitely will affect our immune system. Anxiety, stress, and despair. Try to get out of it. Try to be socializing with other people to stop yourself having to be in such a status of despair, anxiety, and stress. Also using tonics. Why excessive use of tonics? Red Bull, other things you buy from chemists, you buy from shops, and you keep mixing it with water and give strengthening the body of the arms or the legs or whatever you call it. Excessive using of tonics, anabolics, and doping drugs as well. This will actually affect the immune system of the body. Other point is psychological, mental, and neurological trauma. Don't expose yourself to such a trauma. Psychological, mental, and neurological trauma. Another one, which is neglecting some problems. You start to have a cough, then you start to have sputum, the sputum become green, you start to have wheezing in the chest or noises in the chest, and you don't take antibiotic and don't take rest and don't take the necessary medicine for it, and this will affect the well-being of yourself and ourselves. Another one, which is excessive sexual marital activities with your wife. Even this affects the body itself, as I am saying that. Number eight is excessive drinking tea and coffee, because the caffeine has another negative impact on the well-being of the body of the individual, such as yourself and myself. Moderation in everything, and this is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, advised us to do. When we eat, make third for your food, third for your water, and third for your the air actually you breathe into it. The second point of the 25% of is bad things never become good for you. So we said earlier on, too much of a good thing is a bad thing. The second is bad things never become good for you, such as all different kinds of smoking. Never, ever. And you have to stop. Even if you tell me that I got this hubbly bubbly with what do you call it, apple, with flavor, with orange flavor, with strawberry flavor, all this smoke, which is poisonous, affecting the lungs badly. No matter what you say, young men and young women. And what's one of my astonishment to see young girls and young women are having this hubbly bubbly and they smell awful smell like men. So all different kinds of smoking, we should stop using them, inshallah. This is bad thing, never become good for you. Second one, wrong and lawful activities which leads to HIV/AIDS. HIV/AIDS, any activities which led you to be contracting HIV/AIDS, which is to decrease the immune system. In 2017, there was actually more than 770,000 people died of HIV/AIDS and 1.7 million people reported as infected. Sexual relationship with sex workers. And this is, I don't know how to describe it. Young men, I saw them traveling here and there. Even last year, a very bad example, I saw young men coming from certain countries to Bosnia. Yani, yucky, what is this? Those individuals travel, make the effort, spend the money. For what? For something like this? And this is the young men? Oh, how silly. And when they contract HIV/AIDS, their family and their mother and their father will spend the whole wealth on them to do that. Number four from the bad things is the drinking liquor. No matter what you say, you might say that beer is not like alcohol. All of them, as the Prophet said, مَا كَثِيرُهُ يُسْكِرْ قَلِيلُهُ حَرَامُ. It is all haram. No matter if you don't become drunk from a small amount of it. See, you can tell me beer is not haram. It has alcohol and is haram. Narcotic drugs and taking drugs and narcotics and others. So bad thing never become good for you, such as all kind of smoking, sexual relationship with sex workers, wrong and unlawful activities leading to HIV/AIDS, drinking liquor, taking drugs, and narcotics. This is the second 25% in my cake. If on my cake, the first 25% to strengthen your immune system through good food and looking after your body. Second 25% is in my cake is too much of good thing is bad thing, and bad thing never become a good thing, as I mentioned to you earlier, in both sides. The last 50% is complementary program which you have to take it. If these two, this first 55% is 50% is to strengthen our immune system, and too much of good thing is a bad thing for us. Complementary program will be first of all to following government guidelines. Should be all the time, no matter if you agree or disagree with the government, should follow the guidelines, social distances, wearing masks, and other government regulation and guidelines. It's number one. Number two, cleanliness, self-cleanliness, washing your hands, washing your, when you go to toilet yourself, having a proper shower, washing your clothes, and all this kind of cleanliness that we have. Even I mentioned a few months ago in March, I think, how we as Muslims clean ourselves during wudu, ablution, doing istinja, even shaving the hair from the armpit and the private area, and how to cut the nails and others, all as a matter of public health and public hygiene. This kind of cleanliness of the surrounding, from the slums, from the rubbish, all these kind of things which will lead to the presence of insects, rats, and all these sorts of things which bring infection to us. Family bonding and cohesion. Somebody must say, what's family bonding to do with COVID? Family bonding create safety for the children, for the wife, for the husband. We should not see husband beating his wife or wife screaming and beating her husband, and the children screaming amongst both of them, or husband or wife, and mother and father actually are beating the children. The uncertainty and this kind of unsafe atmosphere in the family will impact badly on the immune system of the individual. Of course, sports activity, if you can do it, if you are an old man or old woman, you can do the walking outside the house. Government regulation in education, awareness raising, and fighting illiteracy as well. A role of media. Why should the media keep surrounding us with false and negative news? Please, please, please try to check the authenticity of the news that you air on your media platforms, actually. Civil work and civil liberty and civil society organization, all the civil society organization, that all the local organization have to be a part of building the social well-being of the individual and protecting the individual and guiding the individuals in partnership with the government as well. The role of social media as well, social messaging. Why young men and women on social media platform keep just spreading or sharing unauthentic information? Why? It's wrong. Should be sure that this news or this information are right and authentic before you start sharing it with others. Also, the role of research center, scientific research center, academia, and think tank, we should support them, because we need to know the root causes of the problem. Scientific research, academia, and think tank. Religious institution, they should, because they are the most trusted institution in any country, whether the churches, synagogues, mosques, temples, and others. They should play a very positive role, complementing the role of the government and complementing the role of civil society organization, and building the motivation atmosphere or the motivating atmosphere inside the heart of every citizen, and sending very positive message to individual during this difficult time. Private sector has to deal with corporate social responsibility, supporting research, supporting civil society organization, supporting local community, supporting government program, and supporting individuals as well. This is actually the private sector. The last but not least, avoid excessive use of electronic devices, because it has these electromagnetic waves which can affect yourself and myself. So if I go back to my cake, I said in my cake of how to deal with the herd immunity philosophy of thinking or strategy, I divided my cake into three parts. 25% to strengthening the immune system of my body through taking good food, and through body care, as I mentioned earlier on. 25%, which is about too much of a good thing, is a bad thing, and bad thing never becomes good thing for you, such as excessive eating, drinking, sports, and others, as I mentioned before. And you find the link actually being shared by Ali on the Facebook, on the page. And bad things never become good things. It's a part of the second 25%, which is smoking. I'm just saying this, all kinds of smoking, sexual relationship with sex workers, wrong and unlawful activities which lead to HIV/AIDS, and drinking liquor, drugs, smoking, taking drugs, and taking narcotics. The last 50%, which is a complementary system, which talk about cleanliness, sports, role of media, social media messaging, the role of civil society organization, education, awareness raising, family bonding, following government guidelines, and role of research centers, scientific research center, and think tanks and others, role of religious institution, role of private sector, and avoid excessive use of electronic devices. Our statement at the last is actually, which is mentioned by one of my colleague, young individual, may Allah bless him. He said to me, the strategy of herd immunity gives us clear evidence that it will lead to a wider spread of the infection, which will have a damaging snowball effect on society. Unfortunately. And this can through the politicians 4 months ago. And this might happen to us in autumn, winter this year. So we have to be self-protecting ourselves, taking the responsibility of protecting ourselves, our wives, our children, our loved ones. The second point mentioned by Ahmed al-Sheikh is the rapidly spreading COVID-19 global infection proves what? That the infection was there for a longer period of time and was not recent infection as claimed previously. And this is something I believe in very strongly, that if people start talking about a pandemic in December, this pandemic must have started somewhere silently in August, September, October, November. So we nearly are under 1 year of being attacked by COVID-19. Over the last nearly 1 year, not only 6 months, not only 7 months, not only 8 months. The other point is, which we need to mention before I end my presentation, is do we know the actual number of infected people globally? There are certain countries, and many countries do not announce the number of infected people in their population. I don't want to mention such countries. Many countries in Africa and Asia do not disclose the number of infected people. And whenever anybody dies, they can say chest infection, they can say liver disease, and other. So this is something actually to let us to be aware about the policy or the strategy of herd immunity, which people, politicians are talking about to follow the strategy of herd immunity in this autumn. Let me make the definition of herd immunity again. It occurs when a large portion of community, the herd, becomes immune to the disease, making the spread of disease from person to person unlikely. As a result, the whole community becomes protected, not just those who are immune. Often, a percentage of population must be capable of getting a disease in order for it to spread. This is what we call threshold proportion, was mentioned by MayoClinic.org, June 6, 2020. Thank you very much for being with me, and my apology again for the technical problem happened to my computer and to the Wi-Fi in my house. maybe next time we'll change the computer, as well as we, I cannot change my house, but I'll look at how to deal with it. But we'll share the presentation with you. It should be with the link that Ali will be putting it with the film, with the video. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.